Good morning, everyone.
I am here again with the next session of data visualization. Today we are going to discuss in Python how data visualization is done using bar graphs and line charts. Hello friends, this is Tushar Agarwal. Now these are line chart examples. Look, there are multiple lines here of various colors we need to draw, and there are bar graphs or bar charts, we can say. Friends, in the previous session we have studied about histograms. Now histograms and bar charts are different in the way that there are no gaps in histogram, whereas there are gaps in bar graphs, right? So bar graphs are different from histogram, don't mix them. Now let me start with the first. Yesterday we have used two libraries, NumPy, that we have already discussed, and now I want to tell you something about Matplotlib. Now yesterday I told you that Matplotlib is used to create 2D graphs, means two dimensional graphs. There will be no third axis, means no Z axis, only X and Y axis, and we will plot using Python. Now PyPlot is a library inside a Matplotlib package which supports a wide range of graphs and plots, namely jaise ki hamare hote hain histogram, bar charts, power spectra, error charts, etc., line charts, pie charts. It is used along with NumPy to provide environment for MATLAB. MATLAB is a processor that we don't have to discuss because MATLAB is not in our syllabus. So let me move further with PyPlot. Now what is PyPlot? Python plot. PyPlot stands for Python plot. Python plot. Now plot is a function which we use in further for plotting the lines in the line chart. Now PyPlot provides the state machine interface. It means the user machine interface to plot library in Matplotlib. It means the figures and axes. Iska matlab kya hai ki jo figures aur axes hai, means the diagrams, the rectangular boxes, and the axes means the x-axis and the y-axis of the graph are automatically created. There is no need of user to mention how to create x-axis and how to create y-axis. For example, calling plot from PyPlot will automatically create the necessary figure and axis. Whatever data you provide, on the basis of that, it will automatically make axis. Look, this is my x-axis and this is my y-axis. So it automatically makes this axis. Now let me come to the line charts. First we will start with line chart. Friends, first we must know that why line chart is used. Line chart is used to show a series or trends over that time, means like I will take weather forecast. We will say on today 4th of April weather will be sunny, there is 30 degree temperature, etc., etc. Now what will be it on 5th, 6th, 7th or previous days? So that comparison, that trends over that time, means timely trends, are given by line charts. Now a line chart, we will plot a single line using plot function. We will plot a single line using plot function, right? This is the plot function. How we have to write, we have to pass arguments in it. We will discuss practically when we will move forward with the line charts. Now we can not only just plot a line, but we can explicitly define the grid. That what are the x-axis, what are the y-axis, how labels can be defined, what is the title, how it can be displayed. And friends, there is one and only one function, that is plot, means show function, plt.show. I use plt as Matplotlib library. So there is only one function, dot show, show, which is used to display your diagram or trends over the time. Now let me show you an example. This is how we have to write. First import package of NumPy as np, then import matplotlib.pyplot library as plt. It should be here, sorry for that. Now I have taken an example of year. There are 5 years I have mentioned there: 18 19 20 21 22. Now I have taken two trends, observations, or we will say it trends, the data 90, 92, 94, 95, B is this. Now how I have to plot, just look at it. PLT means my matplotlib library dot plot, the plot function which I am talking about, dot plot. Now here I have put x-axis, now my y-axis, here is my x-axis, this is x-coordinate, this is y-coordinate, and the color, color I have given G, G means green. You can write it as green or you can write it as G. Now if I want to just add my second one, plt dot pplot, here this is x-coordinate, this is y-coordinate, and this is my color. Color should be orange, green, blue, whatever you want. Shall I repeat? Okay, I will repeat. PLT dot plot, this is x coordinate, this is y coordinate, and the color. This is x coordinate. It means the number of times you use plot function is the number of lines are there. Jitne aap plot function lagate jayenge, utni lines aapki graph mein badhti jayengi. Now, x ko maine label kar diya ear se, y ko maine label kar diya some frequency, any frequency I can write. I have given the title data visualization line chart. Yesterday we have given, these three are same in histogram and in title. Okay, the number of times plot function is used, the number of lines are there. Now these x label, y label and title are same as in the previous. Dot show is used with every chart whatever we are discussing. Next time we discuss bar chart, show is used to display the graph. Now let me move further. This is the line chart. There are two lines. First one is first one. We have given G, that means green, and the other one is yellow or orange. Now 2018, this is my x-axis, means this is my year, and this is my y-axis, capital A. So friends, I think line chart is clear to all. Now friends, to draw line charts, we can draw as many lines as we want. We have to use plot function multiple times. So now let me move to the next one, which is bar chart. A bar chart, yesterday, or bar graph, is very common two-dimensional data visualization made of rectangular bars. Now friends, there is a difference between bar graph and histogram, as we have discussed earlier, that there are gaps in bar graph and there are no gaps in histograms. Means in bar graph there is no continuous distribution, means in bar graph there is no continuous distribution. Now let me directly come to the program, because we don't have to calculate anything in Python. We have to make it automatic, to work it automatic. Now I have imported matplotlib, import numpy, now taking label as one dimension, per as second dimension, index. I have made an array here. We have to made an array. What I have taken, length of label, the size of the array should be the length of the x coordinate we are taking. Now we have used this function plot dot bar. Dot bar function is used. This is x axis, this is y axis. Now x label, there is some difference here. Now we have used student name and given the font size as 5, and here we are using percentage and given the font size as 5. Now x ticks, friends, these are the coordinates of x-axis, the points of x-axis where we are, the middle point of your bar graph. This index, comma label x, comma y, font size 5, and rotation is in degrees. It is 30 degree. It is 30 degree. Now title data dot visualization, plot dot show. Now let me show you an example. Look, these are the x-ticks. These are the x-ticks. Okay, these are the x-ticks. This is my title. This is my y label, this is my x label. You can, if you don't want to give font size, it will be by default, no need to give font size. This is bar graph from my side. Now again, what is bar graph? I will show you. Dot bar is used, two coordinates we always require, index and per. Now index is, what is the value of index? That up to the length of label, up to the length of label. Now how many are there? Let me see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Friends, first remember, here we are talking about the length, not the index. You don't have to count from 0. You have to count from 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. If I will change this to the length minus 1, then it will be minus 1. Now in bar, two coordinates are there. X label, Y label, we can send font size. X ticks, Here I have written index means the number of the length of the array. The array is having six elements, so six times, comma, label, what are the values in the label are here. Then font size and the rotation is in degrees, but we don't mention degree. It is 30, 45, 60, and so on. So friends, that is from my side today. Today we have discussed about Python data visualization, line charts and bar graphs. I hope you understood very well. For any queries, you can anytime contact, comment. Stay home, stay healthy, take care of yourself. Thank you.